Hello everybody, and welcome to Zero Trust Workshop for the Infrastructure Pillar. My name is Pavel Kratky, and I'm a Senior Product Manager here at Microsoft. I'm excited to show you in this video how to leverage the workshop tools to strengthen and safeguard infrastructure assets, and how to build a strong infrastructure security posture. This video is for those of you who are looking to deliver this workshop for your customers. If you want to learn more about the overall Zero Trust Workshop model, check the link in the description. Let's get right into it. Let's talk about your role delivering the workshop. While the workshop content helps with structure, the most value customers are going to take away is the insights you provide. As part of this workshop, you will need to offer insights on Defender for Cloud and other related Microsoft products from the infrastructure pillar, including their features, benefits, and implementation strategies. This involves explaining how Defender for Cloud integrates with other security solutions and how it supports the Zero Trust model. You'll also share practical insights based on industry experience, discuss real-world scenarios, best practices, and common challenges faced by organizations when implementing infrastructure security. Part of this is highlighting the importance of securing infrastructure components such as servers, containers, storage, and other workload types. Engaging in meaningful conversations with the customer to understand their specific needs is an important part of this workshop. Encourage questions and provide advice to help them achieve their security goals. For purposes of this workshop, we need participation from various teams from the customer, as many of the areas will require coordination and collaboration to implement the recommendations from the workshop. For example, security operations teams will work with infrastructure and endpoint security teams to ensure real-time threat detection and mitigation strategies are integrated into the infrastructure, enhancing overall security. Another example would be in how compliance teams will have to provide guidelines and requirements in alignment with application developers, ensuring that application infrastructure is built to meet regulatory standards. We highly encourage leadership to join the workshop if possible, as we will be discussing topics that will require their buy-in and support. Their participation will help them understand the strategic decisions needed, identify opportunities for optimization, and support any necessary changes. We design this content to be delivered either remotely or in person. The time needed to deliver this workshop may vary depending on the infrastructure workloads your customer will want to focus on. Detailed breakdown is provided on our website. In general, you should be able to go through the workshop content within the course of 1 day or less. Now, it is important to highlight Zero Trust and the importance of its core principles. Infrastructure comprises the hardware, software, services, networking infrastructure, and facilities required to support an organization. Whether on-premises, multi-cloud, infrastructure represents a critical threat vector. Zero Trust Infrastructure Workshop helps you assess, monitor, and prevent security threats to infrastructure. It supports the principles of Zero Trust by ensuring that access to infrastructure resources is verified explicitly and granted using principles of least privileged access. It employs mechanisms that build detection, remediation, and strong security posture in the assumption that breaches will happen. Zero Trust Infrastructure Deployment Guidance provides key stages of Zero Trust infrastructure strategy, such as assessing compliance with chosen standards and policies, hardening configuration wherever gaps are found, employing hardening tools such as just-in-time virtual machine access, setting up threat protection, or automatically blocking and flagging risky behavior and taking protective actions. In terms of mechanics, the conversation involves guiding the customer through each of these boxes that represent actions the customer needs to take. These actions could involve making decisions to start or stop certain activities or deploying specific product features. If you have an existing relationship or knowledge of the customer environment, it's beneficial to pre-populate the boxes with information you already know. For each box, you will set the status based on the customer's current situation. The boxes are organized in swim lanes to follow a logical sequence using first, then, next approach. It's important to note that multiple swim lanes can run concurrently. This demonstrates to the customer how many initiatives they can parallelize, depending on their bandwidth. We also highlight the implementation effort and user impact in the small bubbles in each box. What you see is an example of how the spreadsheet might look after you progress through the governance and compliance portion of the infrastructure pillar workshop. It typically shows a mix of various states. One thing to watch for, from our experience, is that the customer might start discussing broader topics that help you fill other boxes down the line. For example, while discussing determined business needs item, they might outline their approach and the requirements for various workload types that are further down the workload type swim lanes. In such cases, it's best to let the discussion flow naturally and then fill out the boxes ahead. This approach helps maintain a good flow and momentum and also saves time. Besides the overarching governance and compliance sections, the Zero Trust infrastructure pillar is mainly divided by the infrastructure workload types. In this example, we are focusing on servers. Besides the implementation effort and user impact, we are also highlighting licensing requirements where applicable via similar graphic indications. As part of Defender for Cloud, Defender for Server plan enforces zero trust by hardening infrastructure, setting up monitoring for threats, or leveraging capabilities such as just-in-time virtual machine access. It covers server assets, whether on-premises, in Azure, or across multi-cloud environments like AWS on GCP. Each of the workload type swim lanes is divided into similar sections, starting with determining workload-related protection requirements, going over planning and deployment, and configuration of the relevant product plan. For example, in the case of servers, we mentioned the just-in-time VM access. We will recommend to enable it so we don't leave virtual machines exposed to persistent threats and unauthorized access attempts. Going over to the posture section, we are making sure that server workloads are properly protected with minimized risk of exposure to malware, lateral movement, and data exfiltration. This supports the assumed breach principle of zero trust by ensuring all server workloads are hardened against threats. Each workload section is complemented with response swim lane, which aims to define a clear response strategy to ensure rapid, informed, and consistent responses to threats. Finally, every section contains optimizing and proactive actions in the next columns, such as building automated remediation logic or automatic response to alerts to ensure that threats are addressed consistently and the window of exposure is minimal. Closure is a significant part of the workshop process. When you step back, you realize that you have helped the customer build their strategy. Therefore, we recommend scheduling a closure meeting for about an hour, ideally with leadership present. In this meeting, summarize the big picture, highlighting the positive aspects of what the customer is doing, especially if their leadership is there. Also, identify the top 3 to 5 areas that need to focus on moving forward. Additionally, outline the next steps with you and your organization. This is an excellent opportunity to propose more Zero Trust workshops and additional projects that stem from this activity. We have found this to be a highly effective approach. As we wrap up the workshop, it's important to recognize the value this brings to driving discussions about improving security strategy and adopting Zero Trust principles. Over the course of this session, we walk through the major steps in delivering the workshop and how it can benefit us and our customers. Make sure to check the other videos in the series, and thank you for watching. See you next time.